بذكراك نسعد يا رسول الله.
Speaking on account of some predictive signs of prophecy and its acceptance by the ancestors of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will be a long lasting series. In Surah As-Saff, verse number 6, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told, وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِي إِسْمُهُ أَحْمَدْ. And remember when Isa alayhi salam, the son of Maryam radiallahu anha, said, O children of Israel, I am truly Allah's messenger to you, confirming the Taurat which came before me and giving good news of a messenger after me whose name will be Ahmad. At when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to them with clear proofs, after knowing that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the promised prophet for them, qalu hadha sihrun mubin. They said, this is pure magic. In Sahih al-Bukhari, there is a hadith from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu that states, Allah never sent down a prophet without entering into a covenant upon him. That is, to the effect that if Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were sent down his mission when he was living, it means that when the covenant was held with a particular prophet, when that particular prophet was there, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent with the mission with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then that prophet would believe in him and aid him. Allah also ordered him to take covenant to his people if Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were given his mission during their lifetime, then they should believe in him, aid him and follow him. And this covenant was said in Surah Al-Imran verse number 81. And after the covenant, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the prophets for the affirmation of the covenant. And the prophets, they said, yes, we do. We are ready to believe in him, aid him and follow him. And Allah said, فَاشْهُدُوا وَأَنَا مَعَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. Then bear witness, and I too am a witness. Muhammad bin Ishaq radiallahu anhu stated, Jewish rabbis, Christian monks, and Arab soothsayers all spoke of the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before his mission has the time for it approached. Before the revelation of the prophecy to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the soothsayers and the Jewish, the scholars in Jews, they knew, because they spoke of messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they knew about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their holy scriptures, in Injil, in Torah. It was well defined in every holy scriptures about Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returned to Khadija radiallahu anhu after the first revelation in Ghar al-Hira, and his heart was beating rapidly, this hadith was reported by Aisha radiallahu anha. It says that Khadija radiallahu anhu took Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Warakat bin Nawfal. He was a Christian convert and used to read the Gospels in Arabic. And Waraka was a parental cousin of Khadija radiallahu anha. Once they reached there, Waraka asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you see? When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the things happened, while the revelation was held, and what was the reason for sharing, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam revealed what happened in Ghar al-Hira, Waraka said that is the same angel whom Allah sent to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was Jibril alayhi salam. Waraka added that, وَإِنْ أَدْرَكَنِ يَوْمُكَ أَنْصُرْكَ نَصْرًا مُوَزَّرًا. Should I live till you receive the divine message? I will support you strongly. Because Waraka knew what was going to happen, because it was prescribed in the holy scripture about the promised prophet, about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The complete symbols was defined in Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his revelation. So Waraka knew that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the promised prophet, was this, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he told that he would support him strongly if he was alive when the prescribed community of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could deny him and betray him. And when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to them, they rejected the prophet knowing the truth. The rabbis, the Jews rabbis and the scholars from the Jews were not ready to pass the true message, because as a fear of losing the reputation and acceptance in the community, if they believe in Islam and if they convey the message that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the promised prophet, then they are gonna lose their power, their acceptance, their reputation in their community. Because if they believe in Islam, then they are not getting any dispositions in their religion or in their community. And the later customization and the modification in the Injil, the Bible, which created a great confusion in the Christianity. The truth hidden in the previous testaments were blindly replaced with the New Testaments. And just speaking about the miracles of Prophet Muhammad within a brief time is absolutely impossible. So it's our great opportunity to have a good research on the predictions and about the history of Prophet Muhammad. We believe, although we believe in Islam and we believe that Prophet was the promised and the last prophet, although it will strengthen our iman by having a good research on that. So thank you for your time for me. Assalamu alaikum.